We'll see you then. Thank you. Well, it is fast, like a blast from out of the future. And every time we do a story about it, we have learned all of you are very, very interested.
So when Target 11's Rick Earl found out the push for Hyperloop 1 was going before lawmakers, he made sure we were there to get the update.
Most people are enthusiastic about the idea of getting from Pittsburgh to Columbus in under 20 minutes, or Chicago from Pittsburgh, or your other places in such a short time.
On Capitol Hill, William Murdoch touting the benefits of Hyperloop and a proposed route from Pittsburgh to Columbus to Chicago. He's the executive director of the Mid-Ohio Regional Planning Commission, and they are working with Virgin Hyperloop 1 to develop the first commercial route in the country.
We've been working with our friends in Pittsburgh and Columbus all the way up to through to Chicago to study things like right-of-way, safety, cost, and that information we'll have once our studies are done by about the middle to late summer.
Last year, Target 11 traveled to the desert just outside Las Vegas for an exclusive tour of the world's first Hyperloop test track, where an electric spaceship-like pod riding on a bed of air hurtles through a steel tube. The technology uses magnetic levitation and a system of vacuums to remove air from the tube to reach speeds of up to 600 miles per hour, but they still haven't put a person in the pod. We caught up with the CEO at an open house for members of Congress in Washington, D.C.
We've run over 400 tests on it already, and in this 500 yards that we've built in Nevada, we've already gotten up to 240 miles an hour, which is pretty incredible. I think you'll see people riding in Hyperloop before very long.
Jay Walder is the CEO of Virgin Hyperloop One. He says communities around the country are now lining up for Hyperloop, which the company says could easily be built on highway or railroad right-of-ways.
What's happening is a groundswell of support that's actually coming from the state levels coming up, where people are saying, we really want to see something different.
And earlier this year, the federal government created a new council to study new technologies like Hyperloop. Murdoch says Ohio wants to be on the cutting edge.
And when you think of the opportunities, if you live in Columbus, you can work in Pittsburgh. If you live in Chicago, you could work in Columbus. The opportunity to almost commute between those cities becomes really powerful, not just for travel or fun, but for jobs, for commerce, access to medical care, that kind of stuff. It really could change the whole dynamic.
Virgin Hyperloop One is planning more informational stops in Texas, Missouri, and Ohio later this summer. And they say they may add Pittsburgh to that list. On Mount Washington, Rick Earl, Channel 11 News.
Exciting. Supporters also told us a feasibility study on the route linking Pittsburgh to Chicago is due out sometime this summer. More details now from Rick's trip to the Hyperloop testing facility in Nevada. The company told Rick since the pods are enclosed, they can operate in any weather. They also said tickets would be affordable to all, and they hope to have the first Hyperloop route running by 2026.